Welcome to Grace Goes Deeper, a short video series for people who are exploring topics on Christianity, faith, and the Bible. Today's episode is part two of answering this question, is the Bible trustworthy? Last week we talked about the reliability of the text and how it was preserved and passed down to us. Today let's answer these questions, is the Bible history and is it true? So let's dig in. Ancient writers had two stylistic approaches to their work. They wrote history as fact that needed to be passed down through the generations, or they used artistic poetry to express ideas. In other words, the only categories of writing at the time were history and fiction. There was no such thing as historical fiction. If the accounts of Jesus were fabricated and written as legendary stories, stylistically, they would have been written completely differently. Instead, the biblical authors wrote in the style of history. No one had ever written a made-up story in the style of history before. If a story was made up, it was always written as an epic poem. An example would be Homer's The Iliad. In the Bible, it's much different. Further, if it was fictionalized history, wouldn't the Jewish people have made themselves look better? Instead, the Hebrew Bible is a consistent story of a failing people writing about their failures as they wait for a Messiah to save them. In the New Testament, the disciples of Jesus don't make themselves look much better. They wrote actual events and about their failures as they followed this man named Jesus who claimed to be the Son of God, the Messiah they had been looking for. And further, if it was written as an epic poem, the followers of Jesus wouldn't have included such arbitrary details or mentioned people by name. For example, when Mark writes about Jesus calming the storm, he says that Jesus was sleeping on a cushion at the stern of a ship. Why would Luke start his record with a specific period in time under the rule of Herod? And to go further, Luke mentions rulers from surrounding nations like Quirinius, the ruler of Syria. With this in mind, most scholars today agree that Luke is one of the most accurate historians to come out of antiquity. Even further, you have to ask, if this was a great poem or a lie, why would the biblical authors include specific names of people who were alive at the time the books were written? For example, they mention Joseph of Arimathea, Simon of Cyrene, and Nicodemus. Even mentioning 5,000 people witnessing a miracle of Jesus, the original readers could have gone to that town to confirm that they truly witnessed these things. In including these people, the authors were making a point that these things really happened, and you can ask around, get evidence. This isn't fiction. These things happened. The Bible is one of the only religious texts in history to have external corroboration. Most notably, you have Josephus, a famous Jewish historian. Note, he's not a Christian. But he was an eyewitness during the time of Jesus and records the historical account and authenticity of biblical events. He even records the leadership in Rome, I quote, brought before the Sanhedrin James, the brother of Jesus, who was called the Christ, and when he had formed an accusation against James as a breaker of the law, he delivered him to be stoned. So not only do you have ancient non-Christians verifying the events in scripture, but you also have to deal with the fact that James and other early believers in the text were put to death for sharing the gospel and believing it. How far would people go to scheme the world? How far would you go in trying to persuade the world of something you made up? Those with the Bible almost always were tortured and died in the process of sharing it and believing it. So either you have this fanatical group of people creating the greatest ruse of all time, giving their lives to share a lie, or a group of people who actually saw these things happen and they gave up their lives to write about it and share about it. Lastly, the evidence is simply in the beauty of the Bible itself. The Bible does not disagree with itself, and yet it was written by so many people over such a long period of time. Since it was written over a time period of 1,500 years, the authors never met with each other to make a pact saying, let's construct the largest scheme ever known to man and dupe millions of people for thousands of years. And yet, millions of people throughout the generations have embraced the Bible as true. Even with the ever-changing tides of culture, the Bible has come in as a timeless source for helpful, reliable, and objective truth. It has been used for 4,000 years with the same purpose and the same result, moral guidance and a revelation of God with a message of hope for the world. No other text has been this clear, this followed, or this world-shaping. And as far as the West tries to distance itself from the Bible, it always finds its roots in its pages, with a Savior dead on a cross in a tomb that even the Roman and Jewish officials admitted was empty. This book and its message continues to shape and change the world today. Now, if you still have doubts that the Bible is historical and true, I would encourage you to simply read it for yourself. Start with the book of John and read about this man named Jesus and invite God into that process because there's a lot at stake with the Bible. If the Bible is true and trustworthy and God has given it to us, what is in it is very important. So ask God to show up, invite him to give you answers, and dig deeper for yourself.